Politico reporter Don Jr. was a jerk to preschool teacher when he was 3 years old. The mainstream media has finally found the bombshell evidence they need to bring down the Trump family, once and for all. Journalists at Politico have worked tirelessly to investigate the case, and like Woodward and Bernstein during the Watergate scandal, have stunning proof that could mean the end of Donald Trump. Well, not President Trump. Donald Jr., actually. The shocking claim. Don Trump once mistreated a woman. In preschool. When he was 3 years old. No, we're not making this up. Politico editor Virginia Heffernan is now accusing the president's nearly 40-year-old son and heir to the Trump business of being a big meanie face who needed a time out once in preschool. The Pulitzer Prize committee could not to be reached for comment. My friend Anatole Don Jr. Preschool in Manhattan, Heffernan earnestly posted on her verified Twitter account Wednesday. She asked him to move his mat one day and he said, F, U, B, H. He was 3, continued the Politico editor, who boasts in her bio that she holds a Ph.D. The hard-hitting journalist appeared to be completely serious about her hand-wringing over the alleged incident nearly 4 decades ago, and used it as some sort of commentary against the rich. She quit teaching forever at the end of that year. It's not a #MeToo story, but it was extremely disorienting, continued the journalist, replying to a commenter who called Don Jr. a monster. Many of us are essentially in service roles to the rich, and it takes its toll, she somberly stated. Ignoring the fact that the editor of a national magazine may very well be the rich, at least compared to average global incomes, there are a few questions that beg for answers. Is she implying that her alleged teacher friend quit education forever because a 3-year-old said a rude word? Teachers certainly don't have easy jobs. But considering the horror stories that inner-city teachers routinely deal with, a kid who once swore in class seems like it wouldn't even be on the radar. Which, of course, brings up another point, the entire story sounds made up. We're expected to believe that a snotty remark from a 3-year-old so deeply impacted a teacher's life that 4 decades later, she's still telling the story of the harrowing time her fragile ears heard a bad word. Yes. Completely plausible. I also have a friend who told me that they quit their career as an astronaut, after a 4-year-old Hillary Clinton called her a poo-poo head in first grade space camp. They needed counseling for years just to deal with the trauma. Of course, the real mystery of this story is how an editor of Politico thought that this anecdote was even remotely newsworthy or relevant. Even if we assume that the impossible-to-verify story is accurate. So what? How is this news? By almost all accounts, Donald Trump Jr. is a hard-working, responsible man who is now raising a family of his own. He probably even catches his kids saying bad words once in a while, hasn't every parent? It seems that mainstream journalists are now so desperate, so absolutely frantic to hurl mud at the president's family, that they will dig up even the most arcane story to further their anti-Trump narrative. It's becoming almost impossible to take the media seriously anymore. At the same time, reporters can't understand why the public doesn't respect or trust them. This is the state of journalism in the era of Trump.